A vast desert, 40 kilometers from Dubai's skyline. The sun burns over an empty stretch of sand, where the faint outline of runways cuts through the haze. For years, this place sat in silence, a dream paused by crisis. But now, it's stirring again. Tower cranes rise, concrete is poured, and the sound of engines fills the air. This is Al Maktoum International Airport, the centerpiece of Dubai's next great transformation. A $35 billion megaproject that, once complete, will handle 260 million passengers a year, making it the largest airport on Earth. But this isn't just about air travel. It's about power, ambition, and a city determined to stay at the center of the world. Dubai's existing airport, DXB, has been the busiest international hub on the planet for over a decade. 92 million passengers move through its terminals each year, connecting every corner of the globe. But DXB is running out of space. It's boxed in by neighborhoods, highways, and the very city it helped create. Expansion has become nearly impossible. Every new terminal means demolishing homes and rerouting traffic. Engineers have stretched it to its physical limits. And for a city where aviation powers more than 27% of its economy, standing still isn't an option. Dubai's rise was built on connectivity, linking east and west, business and tourism, luxury and logistics. If it can't grow its capacity, it risks losing that edge. So rather than force growth into the old airport, Dubai made a decision few others would dare: to start over entirely in the desert. 40 kilometers southwest of the city center, near Jebel Ali Port, lies the foundation of that vision, Al Maktoum International Airport, part of a vast new district called Dubai South. From above, the scale is staggering. The site covers 70 square kilometers, the size of a small city. When complete, it will feature 5 parallel runways, 400 aircraft gates, and the ability to process 12 million tons of cargo every year. Its terminals, designed by the renowned architecture firm Koop Himmelblau, are unlike any other. Sweeping steel canopies will cover open-air concourses filled with gardens, waterfalls, and light. Inside, vast spaces blend technology, luxury, and sustainability. More like a city under one roof than an airport. It's a place where passengers will step off long-haul flights into environments cooled by natural ventilation, surrounded by palm trees and water features. A reflection of Dubai's ambition to merge efficiency with spectacle. But this project is about more than just a new airport. Al Maktoum is designed as the centerpiece of Dubai South, a completely new city built around aviation. It's an urban ecosystem planned for more than 1 million residents, where people will live, work, and travel seamlessly. From here, aircraft will connect directly to one of the world's busiest seaports, Jebel Ali, which handles over 15 million containers a year. Just beyond it lies the Jebel Ali Free Zone, home to more than 10,000 companies. Soon, Etihad Rail will tie it all together, linking the airport to Abu Dhabi, Sharjah, and beyond. Together, these create something unprecedented, a sea-air-land logistics triangle where cargo can move from ship to plane to rail in hours, not days. As Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid put it, this will be the world's airport, port, and urban hub, all in one. From the air, the vision is striking, a desert transformed into a global engine of trade and mobility. Construction on Al Maktoum began back in 2007, a time when Dubai's growth seemed unstoppable. But then came the global financial crisis. Work slowed, then paused. For years, the site remained half-built, an unfinished dream in the sand. Now, nearly two decades later, it's alive again. The project's first major phase is set for completion in 2032, with the capacity to handle 150 million passengers per year. Crews are already working on new runways and concourses. A 1 billion dirham contract is in place for the airport's second runway, just the beginning of what will be the world's largest aviation complex. The transition will happen in stages. Cargo and maintenance operations will move first. Then, Fly Dubai and regional routes. Finally, by the mid-2030s, Emirates Airlines, Dubai's flagship carrier, will relocate entirely to Al Maktoum. The existing DXB airport won't close, but it will evolve, repurposed for short-haul and business travel. The timing of this expansion isn't just about growth, it's about competition. Across the region, rivals are moving fast. In Saudi Arabia, King Salman International Airport is under construction, with plans to handle 185 million passengers a year. In Qatar, Hamad International continues to expand after the World Cup. And Istanbul's new mega airport has already become Europe's busiest. In this race for dominance, Dubai's move isn't reactive, it's strategic. Rebuilding Al Maktoum is its way of staying ahead, setting the benchmark rather than chasing it. Because in the Middle East, airports aren't just infrastructure, they're instruments of influence. They define trade routes, tourism flows, and global perception. For Dubai, this is about securing its role as aviation's capital for the next 50 years. Aviation isn't just part of Dubai's economy, it is the economy. The industry supports over 1 million jobs and contributes more than a quarter of the city's GDP. Every additional million passengers means billions more in trade, tourism, and spending. But building Al Maktoum isn't just about flights. It's also about unlocking new land value. The airport's vast desert surroundings will be transformed into free zones, logistics parks, and residential communities, all feeding back into the economy. In a sense, Dubai is creating two cities at once, one built around the new airport and another around the redeveloped DXB area. It's an economic strategy that turns infrastructure into real estate and ambition into growth. Yet, even Dubai's vision comes with challenges. Building a mega airport in one of the hottest places on Earth means massive energy demands for cooling, power, and water. Engineers are designing systems to recycle energy and minimize carbon output, aiming to make Al Maktoum one of the most sustainable airports ever built. But sustainability at this scale is complex. Cooling terminals the size of cities and maintaining thousands of daily flights will test even Dubai's innovation. Then there's timing. The global aviation industry is changing. Economic shifts, fuel prices, and geopolitical uncertainty could all affect passenger numbers in the decades ahead. And as with any mega project, cost overruns and delays remain real risks. Still, if history is any guide, Dubai thrives on risk. Its entire story, from desert trading post to global powerhouse, has been built on defying limits. Visit the site today, and you can already sense what's coming. Runways stretch into the horizon, cranes line the skyline, and the desert is carved into grids, the outline of a future metropolis. Control towers rise where once there was nothing but sand. Roads are being paved, utilities laid, and neighborhoods planned. By the mid-2030s, when Emirates fully transitions, Al Maktoum International will replace DXB as Dubai's main gateway. It will be capable of handling 250 million passengers each year, more than any airport in history. But its real significance goes beyond numbers. This isn't just another expansion. It's a redefinition of what a city and airport can be. A fusion of infrastructure, economy, and identity. Dubai is moving from a city built around an airport to a city where the airport itself is the city. Dubai has already built the world's busiest airport. Now, it's building the future of aviation itself. Where other cities run out of space, Dubai expands into the desert. Where others see limits, it sees opportunity. And when the rest of the world runs out of runway, Dubai builds another one.